we have now Dr. TPS. Dr. TPS, all yours.
Namaskaram, I am Dr. TPS. I am just joined because Dr. Meenakshi had sent a message to me saying that there is a program
this. You're welcome.
5 minutes back. So I don't know the context in which it is happening. I'm basically a mathematician retired from space department. My last tenure was with Manmohan Singh at Prime Minister's Office as Deputy Director for Director General of Security.
Dr. TPS, are you a musician by any chance? What is your connect with Meenakshi?
Meenakshi was my kid's teacher in the Bhavans. That is how we connected. Probably we have an interaction.
Mathematics and music connect together. That's the reason I'm asking you.
I also love music. I conduct a program called Music for Unity in Difference. Every Saturday we used to have a get-together of music people around the globe. I must have connected to more than 20-25 countries, musicians. We have a teaching platform on that. And I'm also exponent of Bhagavad Gita, so I did a lot of programs. So Meenakshi and me work together in many areas.
Wonderful.
So our interaction is for last 20 years. So I'm basically...
Are you working in the NPCIL here? That is fuel processing unit?
No, I took my retirement in 2009 from PM's office. Now I'm a freelancer.
Okay.
But I'm also a writer. Mentor students, teachers and parents. I'm also a management consultant. I have got a knowledge management is my MBA. So I worked with technology management and knowledge management with many different people in this country.
Wonderful, wonderful. Yeah. So can you give us a quick background, Dr. TPS? What does TPS stand for, in fact, as a start?
I am Dr. T.P. Shashi Kumar. I am from Kerala, but now settled in Hyderabad. Mostly I stay in Hyderabad.
Okay. And you go from Cochin,
Ernakulam? No, I am from Kannur. That is the North Kerala.
Oh, wonderful. Did you work in ISRO in Bangalore or did you work in...
I was there in Bangalore. I was there in Ahmedabad. I was there in Delhi. I was there in Hyderabad. I worked in most of the different places. I was there part of headquarters as Program Planning and Project Management Directorate. We are the people who fund how much money is to be given to each projects, how manpower has to be distributed in SRO. I was part of that for some time.
Okay.
I started
part of the Mangalyaan planning that happened?
I was there in Mangalyaan, not as a project, but I was there in some of the strategic applications during that time in Delhi. But I was addressing the whole nation when there was question from public, why Mangalyaan and all that. So I was also part of a spokesman.
We need to have an exclusive half-day workshop for all the experience that you bring to the table, along with music and Meenakshi. Wonderful and welcome.
But my wife is a director for one of the ISRO centers, so she did the mapping of the terrain of moon.
she's the one who actually identified there is water when the rest of the Americans
were
still climbing.
Where there is a cliff, there is a mountain, there is a valley. It's called a topographic mapping
when it comes to that.
I'm also into mapping. I was the one who gave a lot of maps for many wars in India, like Kargil war, maybe Veerappan case and all that.
So in fact, Hyderabad happens to be the center to a very large extent, given the ISRO and the HAL.
Yeah, that is because we have the receiving station NRSC in Hyderabad because it's the center of India. But
so
we do
a lot of value-added services that can emerge out of that content that's available.
Yeah.
I would request you to closely coordinate with Balaram. Balaram is actually interfacing with all the colleges along with the incubation center, which uses multiple technologies as well as communication capabilities for enhancing their courses. And I see a major role for you to actually work along with us in those particular projects. So Balaram, please share your number with sir and have a detailed session later on. We can schedule it. Okay.
I was part of the satellite building project under MANIT. The Maulana Azad National Institute of Technology had a program for building satellites. So I was the program advisor for that program sometime.
Wonderful. Yeah. So I think there are a lot of common connects for us. Then you 100% know both Mahesh Murthy and Ashar Farhan.
Yeah.
Pandey.
Ashar happens to be my junior from public school and also the leader of the LAM in the Ham Radio Association for the country at the moment. In fact, I think I missed seeing you at the convention that we had last Sunday. One of the first things that I am also building into the current incubation center is actually having a replicable module for ham radio and communication as a backup for systems for each and every incubation center that's coming up in the colleges. And I need the invaluable help that you can bring on board for the mapping as well as the networking. That's
good. I've got good connection with most of the colleges. I spoke to more than 1 million teachers, 1 million students. I was also academic staff college director for one of the university centers in Kerala.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Many of you say I also... I'm a life mentor, learned most of the Indian traditional heritage, Vedic, ritualistic practices. I am a meditation master from Himalayan tradition, Swami Rama's disciple.
Okay.
Most of my books are named under life.
Life.
So, I've got poems and Life Made Simple. Somebody was mentioning about... Life is complicated and then wanted to make it simple. My Life Made Simple is one book which anybody can read, open any page and read it. So you get some philosophy. So I must have, for last 600 days, I must have uploaded more than 2000 videos. Every day, almost 2 programs.
Wow.
I do in different varieties of activities, starting from engineering, space technology to Indian heritage. I teach generally students how to learn. So learn to learn is my subject. So it could be any subject.
Wonderful, sir.
So
I have I have
a post-graduation in management. I'm a knowledge management person. I also did an LLB from Osmania University. My MS is in psychotherapy and counseling.
Okay.
So education, I must have covered most of the subjects what is required for people.
Okay.
Dr. Sachin
Kumar, you were going to say something on essence of Bhagavad Gita. I was asked by Meenakshi to speak that, but I don't know whether the context is on that. My interpretations on Bhagavad Gita keeps on varying and changing. So I just finished the other day. I am also an advisory board member for the yoga community, the world yoga community under the United Nations. So they hosted a program on Bhagavad Gita, which I just finished from August to December. Yesterday was my one session where I finished level one. I did it in America. I was there in 2 times and then finished my Bhagavad Gita teaching there. And I was a chaplain in one of the temple. So I'm a Sthapatya Veda person who expertise to know construction of temple and the rituals of temples. So Bhagavad Gita is one small fraction from what I do in the Sthapatya Veda and related to temple rituals. My guru happens to be, I don't know whether most of you know that Maharishi Mahayogi.
Yes, that's yeah. Maharishi Imasti here.
Yeah, Maharishi Mahayogi's guru was my guru. So,
okay.
So we have a lot of tradition to follow from that extent, you know.
I really would love to meet you in person and, you know, learn and exchange a lot from you, sir.
Where are you in, where are you, Balram?
Hyderabad.
I stay in Bhavanpalli now, otherwise I used to stay in Malkajgiri. That's where I stay.
Yes, I'm Lanco Hills Road. I can come down. No issue.
Sure,
Hyderabad. Small. Yes.
So hope you guys like.
Beautiful.
Wonderful.
Lakshmi, wonderful. Very good.
So well thought.
I keep
thank
saying
you.
Pink has got a beautiful combination of red and white.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why do you know that how pink is made in color?
Well, yeah, we use red and white, isn't
red
it?
Red and white. Red stands for danger and white stands for purity. So we keep saying.
Oh wow!
There is a movie called Pink by Amitabh Bachchan. I'm a film critic. I'm a film critic. So I wrote an article saying that many people don't know why the color pink is given as the name, because it was the dangerous activity which the girls did when they could not do anything else. But they are pure, so they had that worry of life. So the pink has got a beautiful meaning. And peepal tree is considered as one of the most sacred because mulato brahma rupaya madhyado vishnu rupine agrada shiva rupaya vriksha rajayate nama. For the number of circumambulation you have to take around either Ganesha, ஏகம் விநாயகே குரியால் யூ ஹவ் டு டேக் ஓன்லி ஒன் பிரதிட்சிணா ஃபார் விநாயகா சிமிலர்லி இட் கோஸ் டு சிவா விஷ்ணு அண்ட் ஆல் தட் த மேக்சிமம் நம்பர் இஸ் கிவன் டு பீப்புள் ட்ரீ தட் இஸ் பிகாஸ் பீப்புள் இஸ் சப்போஸ் டு பி த மோஸ்ட் அண்ட் பீப்புள் கோ அரவுண்ட் பீப்புள் ட்ரீ பிகாஸ் இட் ஹஸ் கோட் ஏ டிடென்சிஃபையிங் எபிலிட்டி ஸோ தட் யுவர் ஃப்ளோ ஆஃப் ஆக்சிஜன் இன்சைட் யூ பிகம் சோ எனர்ஜெட்டிக் இட் இஸ் டு கிளீன் யுவர் பாடி ஸோ மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் அவர் டெம்பிள் ரிச்சுவல்ஸ் ஹேட் அன் எனர்ஜி கன்செப்ட் இன் விச் கிளீனிங் பாடி கிளீனிங் த மனஸ் மைண்ட் ட்ரான்ஸ்லேஷன் இஸ் நாட் மைண்ட் பட் ஐ ஹவ் டு கிவ் சம் இங்கிலீஷ் மனஸ் விச் இஸ் நாட் ஹேவிங் எனி ட்ரான்ஸ்லேஷன் அண்ட் தேர்ட் ஒன் இஸ் இன்டலெக்ட் ஸோ த நம்பர் ஆஃப் டைம்ஸ் யூ டூ திஸ் நமஸ்காரா அண்ட் தென் டச்சிங் த எல்போ டு த கிரவுண்ட் யூ ஆர் கெட்டிங் லாட் ஆஃப் ஃபிசிக்கல் கிளீனிங் ஆஸ் வெல் ஆஸ் யுவர் இன்டலெக்சுவல் வைப்ரேஷன்ஸ் பிகம்ஸ் மச் பெட்டர் ரைட் அண்ட் பீப்புள் ட்ரீ இஸ் ஒன் பிளேஸ் வேர் மெனி பீப்புள் கம் அண்ட் சிட் அண்ட் டிஸ்கஸ் த சோஷியலைசிங் ஆஸ்பெக்ட் இஸ் மச் மோர் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் The temple is a place for socialization. All these poems, 27 of them, I wrote sitting in a temple only in Delhi. And in which your second concept, which says undivided earth, which talks about nature. We believe that nature is part of our property. I keep saying exploitation, we categorize in different words. One of the biggest exploitation is the way in which we eat, the eating patterns. I don't know, two movies have come this year. One is called Cowspiracy and the another one is called Seaspiracy. Two beautiful movies which, if you love nature, you must see both of these movies. So you understand how selfish human beings are. And I don't think the United Nations can save, not country can save. Because the United Nations have a bigger politics than each country because that's a politics of politics. Correct?
Yeah.
So it's only human who loves nature. So here I say is one day if all the human beings disappear from this world, the world will become an undivided earth. There is a lot of difference between the world and the earth. The nature is earth, world is not earth. World is man-made. We created so much of sophistication. And when we say that world is developing, the world is developing, always we associate it with economy. Without economics, no development. But all that what you talk about development is an exploitation. All that you speak about development is called an exploitation.
The cost of nature, that's the reality that's coming.
100%. So it is an exploitation. So don't tell that this is a developed world. That means they exploited the world so much.
That's it, correct.
Correct. So
that is the context. As of far, I would like to consider how do we handle tourism and sustainable tourism along with agriculture and development.
See the word sustainable, the word sustainable itself is a big question. Whose sustenance you are talking about?
To see what we can do beyond becomes very important. So what is that larger role that we are looking at is where I would like the algorithm approach that maybe Shashi Kumar could bring to the table, share his thoughts now, while we all of us just listen to him, and then offer Torres also to share his perspective along with Menon and then come back to the circle. And now it's all yours. Back to you, Shashi Kumar.
So I was only sharing that, you know, when we know the objective very clear, probably we orient ourselves.
Yes, we did not know, like we were like,
yeah,
surprised.
Then what should happen is we should not continue until we know there are takers for this. Correct. So I believe that, you know, we need to develop in all the different ideas what we have and how do we move today so that we can create a better future. That is part of everybody's concern.
Yes.
And that is how I look at probably the tradition of India or history of India, all that yuga, what happened, how education system has to be, all that is essential. Even poetry or maybe stories, even science learning, unless we have a perspective in mind, we don't locate ourselves, become part of the chain. That is where most of the youth whom you are mentioning that, you know, there are a lot of people who are contributory, that can do many things. We keep debating, we keep asking questions, we keep discussing about it. What is lacking is, what are we trying to do with our education? What are we trying to do with learning all this history? What are we trying to do with all the religious practices? Most of the people are blind. They don't understand what is happening around. Because somebody has written a story and then you are only acting without knowing what is your real role. So if every one of us know the role very clearly, probably we know where to fit in that sequence. That's only what I was asking you. It is good. When I go to a social science class, my job is to learn social science. So it is not that it is bad and chemistry is good or maths is good or physics is good. But the context should be understood. Even our education system, we lack this. The teachers also don't know what is the context in which they are teaching. Probably the ritualistic people who do pujas in the temple don't know what context they are doing it. Okay, so that is why the word itself, the ritual, has become only a terminology which we generally use for mocking somebody's job. So the way Balaram was talking was like a ritual for me. Right, webinar is there, I have given a chance, let me talk. I am not like that. I am very casual and understand in the context in which we are here. Got it? So that is only what I was asking.
Exactly, Sachi. Yeah. So in fact, that brings me back, you know, to that poem by Bertrand Russell, the what, the why, the where, the when, the who, and the how, the six slaves. They need to be addressed at every context.
Every context.
Take out the rituality of the entire interaction.
We keep asking.
Doing it for the sake of just doing it, there has to be a purpose behind the entire story, which should be clear to each and every stakeholder.
See, whatever
can engage from their perspective.
Whatever Balaram was telling about the deductive, inductive, discovery, all the styles, apparent style still, that is called e-learning. I have a book written 15 years back on this.
I'm sure.
What it?
So, you see, the entire process of epistemology, the theory of learning itself, has to be recast given the new tools that are available at the moment and how we bring in those tools which we have failed to integrate earlier, you know, which allows inclusivity and the ability of co-engagement for co-creation becomes a current reality tree we have to face. Because so far, it has been a win-lose situation with the nature. How do we create the win-win situation and how do we integrate all parts of what makes up society becomes the key. Not just knowledge, not just lecturing, it is also action. I forget, I see, I remember, I do, I learn.
We keep talking about learning. Learning is entirely different from understanding.
Yeah.
See, the poetry comes from you only when you understand. When you learn, it doesn't come. I cannot learn how to write poetry. When I understand poetry, definitely the context will come. Got it? So how do I understand? That understanding has got a bigger meaning. So if I am not able to make my understanding very clear, your vidya becomes only an education which can be translated. It doesn't become viveka vivechana buddhi. So if uncontextually I speak, that means your viveka vivechana buddhi is lost.
Definitely, Sanjay. Make some music for that region wise and also dance. So we have dance groups also. So we'll make it interesting.
Exactly. And learning. And then also we'll build up a monetizable model, Balaram, which allows them to actually also have an earning for all the artisans and sustainability.
Yes. Thank you. And even Dr. Sashi also may contribute something.
Obviously. Dr. Sashi is going to be our binder right across because he has got the knowledge across the domains, all the domains.
And take everybody's knowledge into the picture to take it to the next level. Pattern.
We need to look at.
Murli, let Dr. Shashi Kumar say. Meenakshi is still there. She will end up the session and we'll close the session after that.
I'm sure a collaborative activity is what is required. We could take experience but not replicate. We know geographically, time wise, the time when it happened in some place, it may not happen today. So we need to be spatially and time wise also shift our focus And if that is understood, our experience will grow much faster. Otherwise, we will duplicate. There is duplication doesn't cost you anything. And we also don't grow by individually, we should grow. That comes only when you work in different situations and different timeline. I think well said, Sanjay ji.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.